Amen. Clap and praise. Glad he brought you out of darkness into his marvelous light. Praise God. Let the redeemed of the Lord say so. Amen. So go ahead and say it. I've been redeemed. Oh, I've been redeemed by the love divine. Glory, glory, Christ is mine. All to him I now reside. I have been redeemed. Praise God. Praise God. You say, what does that mean? That means you've been purchased. The Bible says you're not your own. You're bought with a price. Amen. You belong to him. And he didn't buy you with silver and gold, but he purchased you with his precious blood. Man, that precious blood of Jesus. I mean, know we serve an awesome God who's able to do awesome things. Praise the Lord. Psalm 16 verse 8 says, I have set the Lord always before me because he is at my right hand. And the psalmist goes on to say, I shall not be moved. And in this world, a shaking, convulsing, and trembling world, a steadfast, faithful, unchanging God with him beside me. Praise God. Turn to your neighbor and say, he's beside me. Praise God. He's in front of me. He's behind me. He's on my right. He's on my left. And he does not change. Praise God. Hallelujah. I want you to take hope in that today. We serve a God. He's got you. He knows where you are. And he's a prayer answering God. And we put our faith and our trust in him. And we hold on to that unchanging hand. Aren't you? Isn't that awesome to be able to say that? Isn't it great to be able to say that we can hold on to an unchanging God? He does not change. He doesn't change his mind about you. He loved you the day you were born. You were a brand new baby, never had, just fresh and new, just like it. Everybody loves a baby. But even after you grew up and got rotten, guess what? He still loved you. Amen. When you went on and started living for the world and doing things you shouldn't do, guess what? He still loved you. Praise God. And he loves you today. He loves you right where you are. Doesn't matter where you've been, what you've gone through. He loves you. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, God, for loving me. Thank you, God, for never giving up on me. Thank you, God, for saving me. Praise God. Can you enter into his gates with thanksgiving? Can you do that just a little bit today? This is Thanksgiving week. Can we go ahead and say thank you, Lord? Can we just say this? Say thank you, God. Thank you, God, for saving me. Thank you, God, for loving me. Praise the Lord. We're going to go before the Lord in prayer. Do you have a prayer that only God can meet? You just lift your hand. Praise God. Amen. You look around, you see a hand raised. Amen. Just point up, point at him and just say, I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. There's power in agreement. I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. I'm agreeing with you. Praise God. We're in agreement one with another. We ask anything, the Bible says. Anything. Anything. I don't know what your problem is. You may say, you just don't realize how big it is. Nothing's too hard for God. Nothing's too big for God. Praise God. God's able. Amen. Say it. Say, my God is able. My God is able. Praise God. He's able. Let's go before him in prayer. Praise God. Go before him in faith, believing in a God that does not change. He is steadfast. Praise God, he answered prayers in the past, and he's answered prayers today. What he's done for others, he'll do for you. Father God, we come before you in the mighty name of Jesus. We love you, and we give you praise, and we give you glory, and we give you honor today. For God, you are an awesome God. We hallow your name. What is that name? You're Jehovah Rapha. You're the God that heals. Praise God. You're Jehovah Nissi. You're the God, our banner of victory. Oh, hallelujah. Thanks be unto God who always causes us to triumph through the Lord Jesus Christ. Lord, we give you glory and honor today. We praise you for every person. We thank you, God, right now in the name of Jesus. You know what we have need of before we even ask. We ask you to move, God. God, move on people's behalf today. God, touch, move in the lives, God, of your people. And we'll give you the praise, and we'll give you the glory, the honor in Jesus' wonderful name. Praise God. Now to our God who is great and who is greatly to be praised, let's give him the greatest praise. Oh, let's praise him with the praise that he's worthy of.
Praise God.
Hallelujah. Isn't that wonderful? And we serve a God, you're standing on a firm foundation. Praise God. I will put my hope and trust, amen, in the love of God, in the shed blood of Jesus Christ. Amen. The cross of Calvary where the price was paid for my sin and your sin. And not only that, but he went to the grave, but he didn't stay in the grave. On the third day he arose. When he come out of that grave victorious, he defeated death, hell, and the grave. Praise God. Put his foot on the Satan's neck. The devil was defeated.
Yes.
You and I are victorious today. You're not defeated. Praise God. If you have Jesus Christ, you are victorious. I don't care what the devil has said to you this week. I don't care what you may have felt this week. You are victorious through the blood of Jesus Christ. Praise God. That's good news today. You may turn to your neighbor and say, that's good news. Hallelujah. I hope you don't get tired of doing that. I just need you to help me preach. You stand there looking at me like I'm crazy. I need you to just, man, help me out just a little bit. Praise God. Praise the Lord. God is so good. He's so wonderful. We just love him. Praise him today. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Got another song? Praise the Lord. Y'all want to worship some more? Praise the Lord. Let's worship him. Hope we come into his house and we've gathered in his name, not to be seen, praise God, but to worship him. Let's worship him today. Praise the Lord.
There will be days that feel like darkness. There will be nights of sorrow deep. There will be loneliness that hold you. Bless the moon on my soul. I lift up the name.
What is his name? Praise God, Jesus. Praise the Lord. Say it again, Jesus. Oh, sweet Jesus, there's just something about that name. Praise God. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. I love him today. How about you? You love him? Praise God. Such a wonderful, wonderful friend that we have. Praise God in Jesus. Glory to God. Amen. Lord's laid a song upon my heart. I'm going to sing for you this morning. And right before Dad comes. But I just, the title of the song, Sister Sandra, is, she introduced this song to me. I had never heard the song before. And so I was just beginning to listen to it. The words just kind of rang out. It's just got a great message to it. But I'm telling you right now, religion will kill you. Religion has never worked, nor will it ever work. The only thing that works is a relationship with Jesus Christ. And all you need to know, and the only thing you need to know this morning is you need to have a relationship with Jesus. Being a member of a church will never save you. Does it matter if you're Church of God, Baptist, wherever your name might be on the roll? That won't save you. The only thing that saves you is a relationship with Jesus Christ. Amen. So y'all just worship God with me and we sing this song this morning, okay?
Yeah.
Jesus. Praise God. He's all we need. He's all we need. Praise God. Hallelujah. God bless you today.
Praise God. Amen. Woo. Hallelujah. Amen. Doesn't it feel good to feel the love of God here this morning? Amen. That's what you feel. That's what's going on right here today. How many don't have religion, but you have a relationship? What's his name?
Jesus.
Oh, thank God. Paul said that I may know him and the power of his resurrection. New life. Be born again. Praise God. To be filled with power. Amen. To be guided by his love. Amen. I feel love today. What about you? I feel love because God is love. And I'm among people. The Bible says, know you've passed from death to life because you do have love. One to the other. I love you. I wasn't raised to say I love you very often. You know, it wasn't macho, I think, in that age and in that time. But it was sad. It's sad that, you know, a lot of you in the same boat, you wasn't raised to say I love you. You know, a lot of people had to. Ideal, as one man told his wife, she said, you never tell me you love me. He said, well, I told you I loved you when we got married, and if it ever changed, I'd let you know. That's sort of the way a lot of us are. We shouldn't be that way. We should express our love one to another. I thank you for all your comments and your well wishes on the internet. And my administrative assistant, aka my wife, got me informed. Do you know you've got so many of these hits on Facebook? Praise God. She began to read them all, you know. I said, praise God. So I do get to see them. I do get to hear about them. So don't quit. But I love you. My family loves you. This praise team loves you. And you love them, don't you? Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I've asked Leslie to minister a song before I do preach today. But I'm going to be reading the scripture out of the book of Ecclesiastes, the 12th chapter. If you want to turn in your Bible there, I'll be reading the verse 10 in that chapter today. Leslie, come on, I'll read this scripture and Leslie can minister and then we'll, amen, try to share what God has given us today. Praise God. The Bible says in Ecclesiastes 12, verse 10, The preacher sought to find out acceptable words and that which was written and was upright, even words of truth. The preacher sought to find out acceptable words, even words of truth. Amen. I hope that God has given me some words of truth today to share with you. Would you just pray for your pastor just before Leslie ministers? Father, I love you today and I thank you, God, for every home, every man, every woman, every email, every Facebook message. Father, we know, God, that it's because we love one another that we do these things. And God, I pray that you'll touch and anoint this song and anoint this message. God, we'll give you the glory, give you the praise in Jesus' holy name. Amen. Amen. Worship God with blessing. means, so be it. Praise God. Let it be. Oh, thank God. Glory to God. Thank you, Leslie. Feels good, doesn't it? Feels real good. Praise God. Amen. I'd like to send out a prayer today to Brother Jim Franklin. We want to pray for all of our names that's on the prayer list today. Also, I want to pray for Sister Carol. She's having her final treatment this Tuesday. Praise God. Amen. Amen. Abigail, we want to pray for little Abigail today. Amen. Sister Jeanette just tell me her heart's broken. And it happens when you're dating and things like that. But we know God's. I told Jeanette, me and Teresa broke up 2 or 3 times. Amen. See, you just find out that's what dating's all about. You run on a few bumps in the road, amen, and you learn to deal with them, work through them, and it makes you stronger, amen, makes you stronger. So let's pray for Abigail today, okay? We'll get a prayer cloth to let you take you out of your ass for one. Brother Jim, we love you. Brother Jim Franklin, God bless you. I know you're watching. We love you. We know you love us. Let's continue to pray for him, okay? Father, we thank you today, God, for your love, your mercy. Thank you for this song, amen. Thank you for this other song, God, all the songs of praise. But God, to make us realize that we're not here because of religion. We're here because there's a man called Jesus. Oh, and he so loved us. God the Father so loved us that he done something about it. Praise God. He just didn't say, I love you, but he showed he loved us, and he sent his one and only beloved Son of God, Jesus, and he paid the penalty for my sin and the sins of the whole world. Behold, the Lamb of God that takes away the sins of the world. In Jesus' mighty name. The preachers ought to find out acceptable words, even words of truth. Thank God. In Psalms 90 and 12, the Word of God says, here's the truth. Teach us to number our days, that we may apply our hearts unto wisdom. Number our days, Psalms 90 and 12. You know, we only have so many trips around the sun. I think that represents a year. Once we go one revolution around the sun, 365 days, we only have so many of them. Amen. And we should learn to number our days. We should learn that this life is not it. Amen. We're not permanent fixtures in this world. We're just pilgrims and soldiers and sojourners. We're here for a little while, and then we're passing on. Amen? Praise God. We can sing that song. If you know Jesus as your Savior, you can clap your hands and you can sing, some glad morning in the sweet by and by, I'm going to fly away. Hallelujah. Amen. You're going to fly away. The Bible says the body is going back to the earth from which it came, and the spirit is going to return unto the Lord from whence it came. Thank God. We will fly away someday in Jesus' mighty name. Oh, someone said, I'm not sure who said it, but I heard it and I read it, that one has said it's not the number of days in our life, but it's the life in our days that count. It's not the number of days, but it's the life in the days you have. Amen. Live to the fullest. Amen. Burn the candle on both ends. Praise God. Rejoice. Amen. Look for things. Look for things to praise God about. Look for the goodness of God and the greatness of God. Amen. It's an old story that says every morning out in the desert, you know, the old buzzard wakes up just like the hummingbird. He wakes up, shakes himself, and looks around, and he tells his buddy, hey, let's go find something dead, putrid. Amen. Let's clean up the highway. We, you know, they're doing a good job of it. We need a few more of them here to get all these deers off the highway nowadays. But anyway, the hummingbird says, okay, buzzer, you find what you need, but I'm going to look for the nectar. Amen. And you know what? They both find what they're looking for. And I tell you today, you find what you're looking for. If you wake up grumpy in the morning and fussy and you think everything's bleak and everything's bad, you're going to find, you're going to reap what you sow. So you just better start sowing love and caring and happy things, praise God, because that's what we want, right? Amen. We don't want the bad. We want the good. And God said He'd give us the good. Praise God. Put life in the number of your days. Look for life because we've only got so many. Amen. Words of truth in James 4:14. The Word of God says, what is your life? It is even a vapor that appeareth for a little while, and then it vanishes away. So life is brief. We only have so many days. If we live to be 120, and we probably won't, but if we did, 100 years ain't what it used to be, right? You know, when I was studying about the Civil War in the 60s and going to school, I thought, man, that's 100 years ago. Wow! I thought that was an eternity, but I found out 100 years is just one lifetime. Just one lifetime. Amen. My dad would be 100 years old his next birthday. Amen. If he would live. So, that's just the brief. You know, that's just a brief time. 100 years is brief. So our time here on earth is short. It's like a vapor. It appears for a little while and then it vanishes away. That preacher in Ecclesiastes, he went on to say some more. He said in verse 13 and 14, he said, let us hear the conclusion of the whole matter. Fear God and keep His commandments, for this is the whole duty of man. For God shall bring every work into judgment, with every secret thing, whether it be good or whether it be evil. Praise God. Amen. The psalmist said in Psalm 63, I will bless thee while I live. Amen. How many is going to choose? I believe we're on the majority here. We're going to choose to bless the Lord. While I live, I'm going to bless the Lord. I'm going to praise the Lord. Yes, in this world we have trouble. Yes, many of the afflictions of the righteous. Yes, but the Lord healeth them all. Praise God. So while I live, I'm going to praise the Lord. I'm going to sing praise unto my God while I have my being. In Psalms 146:2. Amen. Your pastor's been thinking this week about some four-letter words. You know, we hear a lot of four-letter words in the world today, don't we? You know, it's even on the airways and the TVs. And Lord mercy, get a hold of one of those rapping things. It's full of four-letter words. I've been thinking of there's some four-letter words that Christians can use. Did you know that? They sure are. I thought about three or four of them here. Let me let you have help. H-E-L-P. That's a four-letter word that God will accept. Yeah. Call upon me, he said. I'll answer them. Help me, God. Amen. Have you ever just throw your hands up and said, God, help me? Amen. Love. We talked about love a little while ago. Love's a four-letter word. If you love, you know God is love. You know God. He that loveth knoweth God, for God is love. Plan. Here's another word. P-L-A-N. Plan. God wants us to plan. Make plans. Be intentional about serving God. Be intentional about reading the Word of God. Be intentional, amen, about helping those that you see that are in need. Because God said, as often as you do it as unto Him. And here's another four-letter word that God will accept. Just move. man. Jason was singing about religion, you know, religion will lock you down. Religion will lock your job. Now, I heard a testimony of a little lady that she said when she first Billy Graham crusade she went to, she was just a little girl, 9 years old, or maybe 10, and she felt the leading of the Lord. She felt God calling her when Billy Graham gave the altar call. She felt like she needed to go to the altar, and she stood up to go to the altar and receive Jesus as her Savior. And her mother said, "Sit down, we don't do that. Sit down, we don't do that." Amen. Religion blocked her for several years, but eventually she received the Lord Jesus Christ, and she became a worker with the Billy Graham Association. She became an altar worker and an usher in those great conventions and great revivals that he had. Oh, praise God. Listen, that's what religion will do. Religion will say, "Shut up, we don't do that." But you see, everything that has breath ought to praise God. I'm telling you the truth. The preacher sought for words of truth to give you today. Let you know, amen, you're free. You're loose, amen. You can give God the biggest praise. You can bring a shofar like David does, and you can be under the anointing of God and blow that thing. And before we leave here today, we're going to have us a peaceful demonstration. Amen. Did you ever think that we might have one of them in church? Praise God. I've asked Tony. Tony's going to play some cadence for us here in a little while. Amen. And the others are going to tune in with him however they want to. But he's going to give us some cadence. And I'm going to ask some of you just to volunteer to come up here with your pastor. And we're going to walk across this front of this aisle here today. And I'm going to tell you how we're going to do it here in a minute, okay? Praise God. But don't be thinking how you're going to get out of it. Just be thinking, "I'm going to be one of them." Amen. Hallelujah. I'm going to be one of them. Glory to God. You see, here's a word today that I want to leave with you. The little four-letter word is here. H-E-R-E. Here. Definition of here is in this place opposed to there. In other words, I'm here and you're there. But I'm here. But you're here and I'm there. So here is in the place. It's in this place. Praise God. How many is here today? If we were to call a row and your name was called, what would you say? Here. Glory. Amen. Because you're present. That means you're present at the time and at the moment. Praise God. Here. We're here in the presence of life and existence that we have. We're here in this universe. We're here in this world. Praise be unto God. Some of you may be asking the questions today. And maybe you've asked this question to yourself, and I think most people have in their life. They may have asked, "How did I get here?" Or, "Why am I here?" Man, the Bible's clear about it. The Bible tells us that in the beginning God created male and female, man and woman, in the image of God. God created he them. He gave Adam and Eve the instruction to replenish the earth. Go forth, subdue, and replenish the earth. And after that generation passed away in the flood, God gave Noah's generation the same command. Go and replenish the earth. Praise God. Male and female. A lot of people confused about it these days. Amen. They're trying to tell our young people, "Well, you can wait till you're 16, 17, 18. You can decide if you want to be a girl or a boy." Amen. It's wrong, 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 wrong. Amen. One old doctor said, "I've been a doctor for 50 years, and there's always just been two choices. It's been a boy or a girl." Praise God. And that's the way it is. God created you that way, and you need to respect what God created you to be and be that. Amen. Hallelujah. nothing to do but be released, be touched of God, be grateful that God made you who you are. The Bible says, when you were in your mother's womb, God saw you and knew you there. Praise God. I want to read Psalms 139 Psalm. Several verses I want to read. Listen, Lord, thou hast searched me and known me. Thou knowest my downsettings, my uprising. Thou understandest my thoughts afar off. When I was using the word there or here, you know, some people will say, I'm out of here. You know, that means they don't want to be here. But when you might just say, I'm out of here when it comes to God, but I'm going to tell you, you'll never get away from God. This psalm tells us about it. He said, for there is not a word in my tongue, but lo, O Lord, thou knowest it altogether. Thou hast beset me behind and before, laid thine hand upon me. Such knowledge is too wonderful for me. It is high, I cannot attain unto it. Whither shall I go from the Spirit, or whither shall I flee from thy presence? If I ascend up to heaven, thou art there. And if I make my bed in hell, thou art there. Man, you can't hide from God. If I take the wings of the morning and dwell in the uttermost parts of the sea, even there shall thy hand lead me, and thy right hand shall hold me. If I say, surely the darkness shall cover me. You know, most meanness happens in the dark. And people think, well, nobody will see me. But listen, even the darkness, even the night shall be light about me. Yea, the darkness hideth not from thee, but the night shineth as the day. The darkness and the light are both alike unto thee. For thou hast possessed my reins, thou hast covered me in my mother's womb. I will praise thee, for I am fearfully and wonderfully made. Marvelous are thy works, and that my soul knoweth right well. Praise God. To say, you may want to be out of here, but you'll never get away from God. You're an eternal being. Did you know that? You will live forever somewhere, heaven or hell. And hell's not a good place to go. Somebody said, well, I'll have plenty of company in hell. No, you won't. No, you won't. Amen. There's no evidence that you'll even know anybody else that's in hell. You'll be in darkness, but yet it'll be a flame, and fire, and torment. You'll probably see your whole life come before you, continue like a movie that is played over and over and over, and you'll see every chance and every time God dealt with you and every opportunity you had to receive Him. Oh God. And not only that, but you'll be in a place that is totally annihilated with the presence of God. No presence of God whatsoever. Even the meanest man on earth is subject to the love of God, is subject to the peace of God, is subject to being in, you know, presence of God. But in hell, that'll never be. Oh God, I don't want to go to hell, do you? No, I don't. Amen. Praise God. Thine eyes did see my substance. God knew us before we were born. And He loves us, cares for us. Praise God. There are two times in God's Word. There are two times in God's Word that I want to talk to you about. And I was really trying to get to the main part of my message today. And I'm not going to get to two of them, but at least I want to get to one. Two times the word here is very, I think, very huge, at least in my mind. It ought to have at least three or four exclamation marks, and I know that's probably not proper. Only one exclamation mark is proper. But in the 2 Kings chapter 7, verse 3, turn there if you would. 2 Kings chapter 7 and verse 3. And hear the story of the Word of God. The Bible says, and there were four lepers. There were four leprous men, and at the entering in of the gate, and they said one to another, why sit we here until we die? Why do we sit here until we die? This story is an interesting story. I know you've probably read it and maybe heard it preached about. But it begins over in the 6th chapter. And that 24th verse begins to tell the story. It begins to unravel. It said, it began to pass after this that Ben-Hadad, king of Syria, he gathered all his host and he went up and besieged Samaria. History tells us that Ben-Hadad was one of the most hideous, no mercy. He was a king, but he was a warrior. He led his nation into war. And he was known as most evil and most tyrant soldier of his day and his time. And he was from Syria, and he came and he besieged the city of Samaria. There was a great famine in Samaria. And behold, they besieged it until, in other words, they locked that city down. Nobody going in, nobody going out, no supplies going in, nothing coming out. For a long time, the Bible doesn't tell us how many months or how many days that they did, but the Bible says that there was such a great famine. And behold, they besieged it until a donkey's head was sold for food for 80 pieces of silver. That's 80 pieces of silver. And a fourth part of a cab, and that comes to about one pint of our measurement. One pint of dung. You know what dung is, don't you? One pint of dove's dung would cost 5 pieces of silver. My Bible has a little note here that says that's what it means, bringing it up to today's money figure. Whenever this Bible was produced, probably more today than it was then. But it tells me that one pint, one 5 pieces of silver would be amount to $640 of our money today. They would pay $640 for a pint of dung. How they ate it, I don't know. What they did with it, they tried to make a meal out of it some way. A mule said, how many's ever worked around a mule or a donkey? There ain't no meat on a mule's head. Bones, right? Oh, bones. I seen a neighbor of mine, he got so mad, he was trying to put shoes on his mule, and that mule was being stubborn and doing everything, jerking her foot down and up and down, and he just got so mad, he hit that mule in the head with his fist, and that probably hurt him worse than it did me, because nothing but bone. But the king of Israel was passing by. It even gets worse, folks. The king of Israel was passing by, and a woman cried out, King! And this is Jehoram, king of Israel. And this woman said, please help me. And he said, how can I help you? You want me to give you some manure out of the stalls? You want me to give you some of the drugs out of the vine or the vat where they stomped the grapes? You know, it was just all he could say. What he was saying, I don't have nothing to give you. And he said, what is your request? She said, my neighbor made agreement with me if we would boil my son today and eat him, that we would boil her son tomorrow. And we boiled my son and we ate him, and now she's hit her son and she's not holding up her bargain. My God. What an awesome, what a terrible thought. We can't even imagine the horror of the thought, even people being in such a need that they even consider such a thing. So I know that God hates the shedding of innocent blood. The Bible tells us the seven things he hates, and one of them is the shedding of the innocent blood. So I believe God decided he's going to get in the program. He's going to do something about it. Praise God. Oh, he's going to do something about it. And you know what he did? Praise God. He talked to Elisha. And Elisha, they were the king, Jehoram. He was so mad at Elisha. He said, God, why don't you get a hold of God? Why don't you pray down something rain? Why don't you do a miracle? And he was determined he was going to kill Elisha. But Elisha showed up and he gave him a prophecy. He said, hear ye the word of the Lord. Thus saith the Lord, tomorrow about this time, a measure of fine flour will be sold for a shekel, and two measures of barley for a shekel in the gate of Samaria. One day they have eaten the child, given $600 for doves done, and here comes that preacher with the word of God and said, tomorrow you're going to get 2 1/4 bushels of flour for $128. You've been paying $600 and something for a pint of doves done. Tomorrow you can get 2 1/4 bushels of flour. You get 4 1/2 bushels of barley for the same price. Then the Lord, on whose hand somebody real important, who the king leaned on his hand, and he answered the man of God. He said, well, how could things be? How could it be if God was opening up the heavens? How could it be? It wouldn't happen. And Elisha said, it's going to happen. You're going to see it, but you're not going to partake of it. And how did God do it? God took 4 leprous men. Hallelujah. Tony, come on with the drums, brother. We're going to bring this thing in for a landing here in a minute. Glory to God. 4 leprous men. They took a risk. You see, there's a lot of things we can think about these leprous men. The Bible says they sat at the gate. They were at the gate of the city of Samaria. They was not in the city, and they was just outside the gate, so they wasn't out into the world. They wasn't out into the camp of the Syrians, but they wasn't inside the gate, amen, with the Samaritans either. They wasn't in and they wasn't out. And I want to challenge you today. Are you just on the fence? Are you not really 100% in for God? Are you just, you know, barely got one leg in and the other leg out? If you have, you better make your mind up which way you're going to go. Amen. Praise God. These lepers, men, they were at the gate. They had a death sentence upon them. And the Bible says they said one to another, why do we sit here? Why do we sit here? And that's my point, to my question to myself today and to you today. Why are we this city? Man, when we could be moving, when we could be active, praise God. Are we just sitting and waiting to die? He said, if we say we'll enter into the city, then the famine is in the city and we shall die there. They begin to think of that. If we go inside the city, we know there's no food in there. We know, you know, we've got a death sentence on us anyway. But we want to live as long as we can. But if we go in the city, we know we'll die. So now, can we go to the host of the Syrians? Can we go into their camp? Will they immediately just jump on us and kill us? If they do, that probably would be the better way. Surely they wouldn't torment us. Surely they wouldn't just, you know, hang us out to dry. Surely they'd just take a sword and just finish us off. Maybe we could die quickly. So they had all that thinking about it. But the Bible says that they rose up. They rose up in the twilight. That means when the sun had gone down and there's still some little daylight shining. That could be morning time or evening time as well. But the twilight of the evening, because they did it in the evening, they went into that camp. Four leprous men made a decision. They're going to walk in the camp. They're going to go in the camp. Lo and behold, they didn't know it. I don't think they heard what their footsteps was doing. Amen. Where my drummer at? Praise God. A cake is sort of like maybe Brother Tony, like one, two. Don't look like they're here, but they're trying to trick us. we get into the camp, they're just going to rush out there and kill us. That's what they thought. But no, they kept walking. They tried to talk themselves out of it. You ever tried to talk yourself out of shouting or praising God? And they said, no, let's go on in. And they made a few more steps, and when they got inside the camp, my, the tents, the fire was still burning. Amen. Some of the rabbits, or whatever they roasted, rabbits, hogs, amen, cattle, goats, steers, I don't know what they had, but they had food. The Bible says that those lepers went into the tents, and the fire was in there, and the food was in there. Woo! They began to, what would they do? They began to eat, and praise God, they began to fill up. They said, hey, daylight's coming. You read that story that says it's going to get day here, and if we're still here at that time, we're gone. And we won't make it. And we're not doing well. We're not doing right. Praise God. By not going back and telling the citizens of Samaria that there's food, plenty to eat. There's plenty to eat out here. And the ark of the enemy. Praise God, and then took off. Your enemy, the devil, your enemy, fear, your enemy, whatever your enemy is, it will flee if you'll begin to move, if you'll begin to march. Praise God, under the glory of God. Hallelujah. Oh, if you've got an enemy today, praise God, as they get a song going, praise God, amen, we done marched in, and the enemy gone.
Yes.
thank God. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. They had to do something risky. You know, you have to do some things that are risky. It's a risk factor. But once you take that risk factor, then you do something that's real. Amen. Real. Praise that God is real. Amen. Loving people is real. Praying for other people is real. Feeding the hungry is real. Bringing coats in, amen, to keep them warm from the cold is real. Thank God. I'm not saying that we are not doing anything, but I'm telling you today, we don't want to just sit here until we die. We want to be active, 100% active for God. Religion ain't working anymore, but relationship surely will. Praise God. Hallelujah, hallelujah. I know my Savior. Do you know Him? Tell somebody you know Him. If you have to tell yourself, I know Him, He's my Lord, He's my Savior. Glory be to God. Amen. He's delivered me from something worse than leprosy. That's sickness of sin. Sin represents, leprosy sort of represents sin. Amen. We all have sinned. We've all got leprosy. Or at least had it till God took care of it. Amen. Amen. He's glad that He did. Praise God. Amen. Cindy, we're going to go ahead.